Section. Welcome to New York and welcome to Show and Tell. My name is Billy and I live in Manhattan, and today I'm going to take you on a little bit of a tour of my woolly inspired neighborhood. It's something that I really wasn't paying attention to before, but now suddenly everything is coming up sheep and wool and knitting. So stay tuned and off we go. Welcome to Union Square, my neighborhood of 43 years. It's a kind of dreary day in my little vintage corner of town. You see some beautiful old architecture. And I'm on my way to a pretty spectacular landmark of a store that I think won't be too crowded today because we're still sort of under lockdown and because of the weather. But it gives us a chance to stay together a little longer than usual. Not too many cars. West 14th Street, usually this would be packed with vehicles. And like a true New Yorker, typically would cross on a red light if there was nothing coming. Here we go. Getting a real slice of New York today, kids. Food trucks. Some magnificent old architecture. Our local multiplex 14th screen theater, you can see temporarily closed. It's not the only movie theater in the neighborhood. We have several others that are in walking distance. One of the great things about New York. And rest assured, New York will be back. It doesn't sleep, but sometimes it snoozes. Okay, if you're really observant, you have a good hint of where we're heading. So established 1927, they bill themselves as having 18 miles of books. Outside, there are always these stands with assorted cheapy lions, and now we're going to go in. We've never been here. I can't believe. It's nice and empty. Good for us, not good for their business.
Oh, you're not. I'm just visiting. Are you visiting too?
So I'm going to take the stairs. And you'll see there's all kinds of categories. It's on the ceiling. I think the books of interest are back here. Well, they also have needle point, but here is specifically the knitting section. So that was crochet, but all the way on the top, which they have these moving ladders if you want to get all the way up. Right now these books are above my head, and then there's another layer up, and two more layers above that. It's the only way I can really get those to show you is probably with the ladder. Let's just take a bit of a close-up. They also have embroidery. And sewing. Let me see if I can find anything specifically vintage classic knits, heirloom knits. Here's one, although it's not vintage, knits. There are some kind of vintage-inspired things in here. The models certainly look vintage, their hairstyles. And this book by Judith McLeod O'Dowd, Living, does have by the decades, not glamorous though. This they're saying is 1940s inspired Art Deco quilt. I'm not getting that, but to each his own. And then just because we know him in our community, the Sockmatician. I thought you might enjoy seeing that his book is right here next to Clara Park's. Maybe you can. This is Union Square on a Saturday. The northwestern side is where the green market is. It's been here 4 days a week for decades. Just wanted to give you a little flavor of the crowd level. Pre-pandemic, this place would be so packed, I wouldn't be able to stand here. People would be jostling me out of the way. But I particularly wanted to come here today to show you the Catskill Merino farm, sheep farm booth. Clara Parks, in her book Vanishing Fleece, wrote about Eugene Wyatt, who started this flock of Saxon Merino sheep, probably the largest such flock in the United States. And here's some of the yarn that they're producing. Look at the array of colors. Really astonishing. I thought that everything would be neutral grays, ivory, black, but nope. They're doing a remarkable job of dyeing. And they're also using great precaution. I love this. Before and after, please cleanse. So, here's their little sign. Happy to announce you can find them on Instagram, and I know they also have a website. Okay, I'm sorry about the hum of the traffic. It is New York. I've walked past here, if I've walked past once, I've walked past 1,000 times. I never saw the American Woolen Building. Let me zoom in. The little sheep over the door. Sometimes the tops of these buildings have interesting ornamentation as well. Maybe nothing much on this one, but isn't that something?